Liquid water at 200 kilopascals and 15 degrees Celsius is heated in a chamber by mixing it with superheated steam at 200 kilopascals and 300 degrees Celsius. Cold water enters the chamber at a rate of 2.4 kilograms per second. If the mixture leaves the mixing chamber at 55 degrees Celsius, determine the mass flow rate of the superheated steam required. As usual, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the heat exchangers and mixing chambers main lecture. The link to that 9-minute lecture and all the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. What we know about mixing chambers like this is that there's a mass conservation, and from what we learned in the main lecture, that the energy conservation only takes into consideration enthalpy values. Combining the two, meaning substituting M3 in terms of 2 and 1, we get an expression from which we can solve for M2. The question to this problem. This expression shows us that we need to find the enthalpy values for 1, 2, and 3. Inlet 1 is liquid water, and at 55 degrees Celsius, so is what we get at the exit at 3. For the most accuracy, we should use the compressed liquid tables, but since a pressure of 200 kilopascals is too low for any of the subtables we have there, we use the approximation we learned about in the specific heat for incompressible substances main video, link below. The specific enthalpy at a given pressure and temperature can be approximated as the specific enthalpy for a saturated liquid at that temperature, plus its specific volume at that temperature times the difference between the current temperature and the saturation temperature. If you don't remember this, the link to that video is down below. Therefore, for inlet 1, we write down HF, VF, and the saturation pressure at 15 degrees Celsius, and for exit 3, we write down HF, VF, and the saturation pressure at 55 degrees Celsius. We substitute these values and find the specific enthalpy values for 1 and 3. Remember that alternatively, if you don't need that much accuracy, you can just assume H1 and H3 to be HF at their respective temperature, without correcting for pressure. It's always good practice to account for pressure, but in this case in particular, due to the low pressure values, it won't make much of a difference. As for H2, since we have vapor, we go to our superheated tables for water, specifically for 200 kilopascals, and look up a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius to write down the enthalpy value. With all three values for specific enthalpy, we substitute them in the expression for mass flow and obtain the mass flow rate of superheated steam at inlet 2. And that's it. If you want to check out other examples in the heat exchangers and mixing chambers topic, make sure to check out the links I left in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermo course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!